for tonight's SEC gymnastics matchup between the Arkansas Gymbacks and the LSU Tigers. I'm Bart Connor, along with my fellow Olympic medalist, Kathy Johnson-Clark, broadcasting from our respective homes. Well, Kathy, these two teams met last week in Baton Rouge, and man, it was a close one.
Closer than anyone expected. We got our first glimpse of LSU freshman Haley Bryant, who launched her vault like a rocket. Arkansas threw down the third highest team bar score in the nation last week to take the lead after rotation one, then held their own on vault. Strong bars by LSU, and veterans like Sammy Durante boosted the Tigers back on top after two. Third rotation was a mixed bag for LSU as beam nerves creeped in. Arkansas turned up the heat with a near-flawless performance from Sophia Carter. Razorbacks led going into last event and fought hard on beam, while LSU set up Kaya Johnson to do what she does best. And with a jeweled stick crown and 10-0 score, it gave LSU the win by just 0.2 of a point.
So the stage is set for a rematch in this home-and-home series. There is Jordan Weaver in just her second season as the Arkansas head coach, of course, world and Olympic gold medalist. She was three seasons a volunteer assistant at UCLA, her alma mater. But now at just 25 years of age, the youngest head coach in NCAA gymnastics. Her team is led off by Madison Hickey, the sophomore from Illinois, who will lead them off. She's known as a powerhouse and a very springy vaulter. Sometimes she even needs to tone down her power, Kathy.
She's doing a full twist in Yurchenko. 9.5 start value, a little bit of a high position in the air, and the hop back.
Arkansas, of course, the home team. They get the Olympic order, which is vault, bars, beam, and floor. The visiting team, LSU, they do the flip-flop of that, meaning that they start on bars, go to vault, then they'll do floor, and they have to finish on the beam. So the leadoff on bars is the spectacular SEC Freshman of the Year, Kaya Johnson. Had a 9.825 in a leadoff position last week.
And I really like her in this leadoff spot. Very strong routine to get LSU going on this event. Watch the transitions between the bars and pay attention to those handstand positions. They need to be right on top of the bar in that vertical position for no deduction. Double layout dismount, just a slight hop back. Good start for LSU.
Last year, she averaged 9.875, and she was typically in that leadoff position. Very impressive. Abby Johnston will be next up. She's a transfer from Nebraska, and she's already become quite a leader on this program. She's a junior.
Last week, she rushed the pre-flight just a little bit, didn't get a good block, so I'm really looking for her to settle down and channel the adrenaline that you get on this event. To Yurchenko vault, much better vault this week. She's happy with that. Of course, the hop back, but it was a much more balanced vault. She got better height and distance this week. Got those arms back to set up the block. Much better vault.
And now, by the way, her teammate Madison Hickey led them off with a 9.75 as we go back to the bars for LSU. Waiting on the score for Kaya Johnson. Bridget Dean, the senior from Florida, will be coming up next.
Starts with a big single bar release called a Ray. Pretty good position on those hands. That little rushed into that bail handstand. You want a little bit more flight on the bar, so you really hit that handstand position, legs apart at the bottom of that giant. Double layout, little bit of leg form, but a nice job.
NCAA gymnastics rules in dual meet competition. Six gymnasts per team compete in each event. Just the best five scores count towards that team total. The team with the highest cumulative score on all four apparatus wins. And as I mentioned earlier, the home order, vault, bars, beam, and floor, goes to the home team. Abby Johnson's score is coming in as we get ready to see Savannah Panisi. What a moment for her, coming back from an Achilles tendon tear.
Made a lot to do moment. Nice height. She was a little off center, so they'll take a slight deduction for not landing right in line with the table. But I really like the straight body position. She flares those arms out at the end. Of course, that step at the end will be a deduction and slightly off to the side.
Before her, her teammate for Arkansas, Abby Johnston, had a 9-8 after Hickey's 9-7-5. Kaya Johnson's score for LSU on the bars was a 9-8-2-5. We'll wait for Bridget Dean's score, but this is Olivia Dunn, exciting new freshman from New Jersey. Last week had a 9-8-7-5 in her debut performance.
Beautiful combination to open this routine. Tkachev to the Pak Salto down on the low bar. Nice long swing, really hits that handstand right on top of the bar. Well done there. Double layout, little bit of leg form, just a little soft in the knees. But another strong routine for LSU.
She's been struggling with a bit of an ankle sprain, so limited just to the uneven bars at this point in the season.
Notice how her feet flex just a little bit and the knees got a little soft in that layout position. These are the kind of things you'll see them really polish as the season goes along.
Jordan Olszewski, the freshman from Alabama, will be next up for Arkansas.
This is a really strong vault in the middle of the lineup. If she gets that good block that she can get.
This is a much improved event for Arkansas.
Very, very clean Yurchenko vault. Keep in mind that the start value, so the maximum score that a Yurchenko full can score is a 9.95. They look for good height and distance. She sees that landing. Hop back, a little bit of a pike down, but not much.
Here is freshman Haley Bryant. What a sensation she is, Kathy.
And she swings so dynamically through this routine. Very, very clean so far. Showing off the handstand position. Nice position on that bail. Love the patience that she shows on this event. Really waits for everything, doesn't rush anything. Double front, step forward on the landing, but the rest of the team was super solid. Really like this transition, the bail to handstand to low bar, right to that handstand position.
Sarah Schaefer will be next up for Arkansas on the vault. 9-8-2-5, the score for Jordan Olszewski. By the way, Abby Johnston and Savannah Panisi, both with 9-8s, have career highs. Welcome to our audience joining us after the Auburn-Kentucky meet. We are here in Barnhill Arena. Tonight is LSU visiting the Gymbacks of Arkansas. I'm Bart Connor along with Kathy Johnson-Clark, and we're thrilled you joined us. This is the second week of SEC Gymnastics, and we're off to a terrific start. These two teams met last week in Baton Rouge, and it came down to the wire. Separated by just 0.2 of a point, LSU got the win. And so this is the home-and-home rematch. Today we're in Arkansas. This is Alyona Shenikova.
Little bit rushed on that first handstand. Nice release combination from high bar down to low. She has plenty of difficulty in this routine, including the dismount. Double layout, a little bit of a pike open technique on that dismount. Came out with a really good landing.
Kathy, quick recap on last meet's week. 0.2 of points separated the two teams, and of course it came down to the final rotation. Kaya Johnson got a 10 on the floor to help secure that win. It was a thriller, wasn't it?
It absolutely was, and I think it was a great start for both the teams for different reasons.
See the scores there on vault, very solid. This is a much improved event for Arkansas as we get ready to see their anchor performer, Kennedy Hambrick.
With a 1.5 twist, oh. Well done, look at that landing. They built in that lineup to that moment, the biggest vault of their lineup. Yurchenko 1.5 twist, 10-0 start value, hung on to that landing. Now on bar
She did the all-around last week and is scheduled to do the all-around today as well. Outstanding start on vault for the home team. Sammy Durante, the veteran senior, was outstanding in her opening performance last week as well.
And just an incredibly dynamic and reliable leadoff last year. Now the anchor of this team. Love the way she swings bars, just with reckless abandon. She attacks every single skill, every handstand. Dismount, half in, half out. Finds that landing, very, very well done.
The last three scores for LSU on bars are 9-9s or better. Aliona Shenikova, their highest score, 9-9-2-5. A couple of days ago, Kathy interviewed Jordan Weber. And when we come back, we'll have that interview for you.
And chose to stay as our volunteer coach. And I said, Joe, you're like, this is, if you want to go in a career, they're offering you positions. And she said, no. She says, I want to be a head coach one day, and I want to learn from you more than what I've just learned as a team manager. She says, I really want to learn how to train champions at the highest level while maintaining their dignity and the love and development of them as whole human beings and not just as athletes.
Well, I don't know how Jordan Weaver could have any better mentor than Valerie Condos Field, the legend coach from UCLA and seven-time NCAA champs. There are the scores after the first of four rotations. LSU 49-4-2-5 on bars. Arkansas improved their vault score by over 0.2 from last week, a 49-1-5 there. I mentioned that Jordan Weaver is quickly bringing the gym backs as a team to be reckoned with in the SEC. Well, Kathy caught up with her earlier this week and they had a terrific conversation.
Jordan, entering your second year as head coach, what did you learn in year one, abbreviated as it was, and how are you hoping to build on that this season?
I learned so much on a daily basis in the first year, just coming in as a new head coach and managing all the different pieces that make up a gymnastics program. You know, a lot of those things, a lot of those challenges that we got through in year one, we're definitely learning those lessons and bringing them into year two. And all the resilience and the strength it's requiring from our coaching staff and our team, I feel like we were prepared for it.
You were mentored by one of the very best NCAA coaches, Valerie Condos Field. What did you learn from Miss Val that you're imparting in your own role as a head coach?
You know, my coaching philosophy really stems from what I learned from her, and that is, you know, every single athlete has to be coached as a whole human being. Every single athlete is motivated differently, and it's my job to figure out as a coach what's going to motivate them and how to challenge them to show up every day and be a better version of themselves.
What have been the biggest challenges or even pleasant surprises you've faced this season due to COVID?
Just the sacrifices they're having to make socially. I think that's been really hard in terms of mental health. That's been a challenge, but at the same time, I'm so impressed with the way the team is even more connected this year. And to be able to do that amongst all the challenges is really, really cool. It says a lot about just what they want and what they're shooting for.
Well, her gym backs finished the 2020 season ranked 18th in the country. Well, this year, after just one meet, they're already up to 9th and in the top 10 on all apparatus. Don't go away. More gymnastics when we come back. I'm Bart Connor along with Kathy Johnson-Clark. We have a good one here after the first rotation. LSU leads by .275, and look at that score, 49-4-2-5 in the bars. Ties Oklahoma with the top score in the nation so far this year. Here is Elena Arenas on vault for LSU.
A very strong vault for LSU to begin with. I'll tell you what, if that first event is any indication, aggressive gymnastics and stuck landings, they score big here, so they are going after it. Just a couple of tiny little things in that vault, slight pike in the air, but such clean form in terms of legs, squeezing those legs and feet together.
Arenas, the daughter of Kim Arnold, a former Georgia gymnast. Bailey Lovett now up on bars for Arkansas.
Opens with a Ray, just a little flexed feet as she regrafts the bar. Nice position on the bail to handstand. Arkansas did so well in their first meet on this event, and that's what they're trying to do here. That final handstand, they're all gonna try to hit it perfectly.
Ranked third in the nation after that opening meet on bars. This is a much improved event. Although Jordan Weaver and Chris Brooks, you see him there as the assistant coach, they acknowledge that this is the event where they lack a little bit of depth. Aliona Shenikova will be next up on vault. You can see last week she struggled and sat down her vault. But after that outstanding start on the bars, let's see if she can keep that momentum.
It was nice to see her in warm-up, really trying to go big on the vault and step forward rather than trying to stick right off the bat. Little bit of stiff-legged landing there. I think she still kind of has that stick in her mind, and you really can't get ahead of yourself and try to land the vault before you go big, but much improvement from last week, so she's excited.
She herself coming back from an Achilles tendon injury a couple of years ago, so they have to manage her numbers. Take a look at the points of emphasis on bars, Kathy.
Well, we talked about those handstands. The judges sit right on the bar. They want to see him right in that vertical position. There's no deduction if you're within 10 degrees of it. And then those releases, you want to see big air and good form, and of course, the landing. Don't give away a deduction on the landing.
Bailey Lovett had a 9-8. This is Chiara Gianfana.
Ooh, short on that final handstand. Everything else I think she'll be pleased with, especially the landing on her full twisting double back dismount. That was terrific. But she competed short on the final cast.
She was an all-arounder for most of last season, but she has a foot injury, so we'll only see her in the bars tonight for Arkansas. Chase Brock next up for LSU on the ball. 9-8 was the score for Arenas. Shenikova a 9-8-2-5.
Another Yurchenko full. Really nice form in the air. I love how close her legs are, just glued together, feet together throughout the whole vault. Very nice side view. This is the view the judges get. Just that slide hop at the end will be a deduction.
And now, on bars for Arkansas, Jillian
Rutz, the freshman from Lebanon, South Lebanon, Ohio. Very young team here at Arkansas, just three seniors. Four freshmen on this team and two transfers, one from Nebraska and one from Michigan.
Now when you watch them cast a handstand, it should look easy, no muscle. Perfectly straight arms and then right to that handstand position. Opens with the Takachev on high bar. Clear hip, oh no. Underdid the clear hip, she'll come down. She went the wrong way. She didn't quite finish the clear hip to handstand and didn't have a cover for it. She should have gone the other way, so swing down and do the transition to low bar. She will probably repeat that because I believe she needs that connection for her bonus points.
So the gymnast has beam today as well.
Gymnast has 45 seconds after a fall. It's 5/10 of a point off for the fall. 45 seconds to remount. There's the clear hip. Done well this time. To the bail, right to handstand. Nice job regaining composure, getting back into the swing. A little short on that final handstand and a little too far over on the full pirouette. Just a little off throughout the whole routine. That's too bad.
Good time to remind the viewers, six athletes on each team on each event. Just the top five scores count towards their team total, so they can drop a low score, but they would hope not have not any more mistakes than that. There is the head coach at LSU, Jay Clark, in his first season as LSU head coach. He's, of course, 30 years coaching, mostly at Georgia. And and he took over after the retirement of Dee Dee Bro. Sarah Edwards now for LSU on ball.
And what a thrill to see her back. Injured last year, missed most of the season, and to see her back so strong. Big 1.5 twist, 10-0 start value vault.
All-arounder for Arkansas, Sarah Schaefer. Last week she struggled a bit on beam, but consistent on the other events. She's typically a 9.9 plus in all four events when she's on.
She's beautiful on this event. Watch the nice long lines, good patience on her swing, no rush at all.
High score over on bars for Arkansas so far. Kiara Gianfagna, 9.875, career high.
She finessed that handstand out of the bail. Went for that last handstand. Well done. Nice giant swing. Double bail. Finds the landing.
That's another Arkansas rebound.
Outstanding coming after Jillian Rutz had only a 9.125. Just what the gym backs needed.
Nice floaty. Double layout, throws that head back. She knows she's hit a good one.
Aya Johnson, you see her score from last week, and she already got off to a good start today. Had a 9.825 on bars in the first rotation.
Everybody remembers her double twist. It's a huge vault from last season. Only doing the full to start this season off. She does it so easily. She was a little bit under-rotated on this. Sometimes it's harder to do the easier vault. See how her chest was a little bit forward, so she had to take that step forward, which shows it was slightly under-rotated as well.
So far, 2.98s and 2.9825 for LSU on vault as we go back to bars. Kennedy Hambrick, you see her score last week, notched her 10th place finish in the NCAA. Sarah Schaefer's score is in. It's a career high, 9.9, just when they needed it.
Now you're going to see one of the few E release moves here on the single bar. She does it right after this blind change. She'll be in a pike position. Pike. Oh, no. Missed the release point. Oh, that's a shame. I'm wondering if she's going to repeat the element. She kind of missed the setting up the skill. You'll notice on that blind change, she was way too past vertical when she made the pirouette and probably just had way too much swing. Timing was off. Nope, going to continue on with the routine from the overshoot. Big missed opportunity here for Arkansas and short on the final handstand. Beautiful dismount, a little bit of a balance correction on what would have been a stuck landing.
That's unfortunate because now Arkansas will have to count a missed routine in this event.
It's exactly opposite of what happened last meet. They went in a little bit nervous, not sure what to expect on bars, and then outperformed what they expected.
Kathy, this will be a highlight without question. Haley Bryant's vault, one of the best in the world.
It's a rocket launch. Front pike cap, and she opens the arms out to the side. This is an absolutely gorgeous vault. She didn't get the stick this time, but this vault is extraordinary. She has so much explosive speed coming in. Just slightly under-rotated it. This is going to be a fun vault to watch all season long.
Yeah, few people on the planet can do it that well, no question about it. Maggie O'Hara will be in the anchor spot for Arkansas here on the bars. Added pressure now that they will have to count one low score.
Now this is when you want someone like Maggie in this position. So much experience. She came and joined the team and immediately was a leader. And that's really what they hoped to get, not just her great gymnastics. And this is a pressure situation.
transfer from Michigan.
Absolutely gorgeous. First cast to handstand. Also finished that blind change in handstand. Beautiful work, showing those vertical positions. Patient swing, no rush, excellent technique. Double layout, love that, gorgeous position there. That's gonna be a huge score. Done to come up with that routine, because it is a pressure situation. They're already counting a fall.
We'll come back and update the scores. And earlier this week, I had a chance to sit down and interview LSU's Jay Clark. We'll have that interview when we come back to Fayetteville.
What lessons do you take from Dede Bro to help you prepare this team?
I think from Dede, the greatest thing any of us take from her is her energy and her enthusiasm. I think that's something that I really appreciate about her, in addition to just being so grateful to her for the opportunity when I desperately needed one.
You seem to have a very balanced team this year with some very high-profile newcomers and some veterans. So how do you assess this team and your depth overall?
I love the balance of this team. I think this team has a little bit of everything. If you like powerful gymnastics, we've got that. If you like style and grace and artistic quality, we've got that too. I think in a sport that is so subjectively based, that's important to have. The most successful teams I've been associated with in my past had a little bit of everything, and I think we have that.
How impressed were you with the Razorbacks last weekend?
I was very impressed with Arkansas. I think Jordan's done an amazing job in her second year of having those kids mentally prepared to go on the road in their first meet and execute as well as they did. It is a little odd to see the same team, you know, back to back, but the reality is it doesn't matter. We talk to our team all the time, year round. It's about competing against everybody in the country every time we get an opportunity to go. And so we'll be sharing the floor with Arkansas, but both of us are competing against everyone. That's how we're measured.
So we're at the halfway point in this dual meet. You see the score there. LSU has a lead of 0.725 over Arkansas. Arkansas had three career highs, including Maggie O'Hara's 9.95 on bars, but unfortunately, two falls have held them back. When we come back, they'll go to the beam. LSU will be on the floor. There is Kaya Johnson. You see three career 10s in her freshman campaign on vault, beam, and bar. She just needs one on the floor exercise. She needs one on bars to complete the gym slam. Kathy Johnson Clark, she is something else, the SEC Freshman of the Year.
Such an exciting gymnast to watch. And what was so impressive, beyond getting a 10 from the judges, is that she had a fall on balance beam, and she recovered, regrouped, and came up huge when her team needed her for that 10-0 on floor to clinch the win for LSU last week.
This is the meet summary at this point. You see three career high scores for Arkansas on the bars, but those two falls, one of them had to count towards their team total. So they trail LSU by 0.725, and they go to the beam in this rotation. Currently ranked fifth in the country in this event, Arkansas is, and this is Bailey Lovett.
Opens with a fun candlestick mount. I don't know why people call it that, but I've heard it called a backflip catch. I think it's more like a back toss to chest stand, but. Really nice position on those leaps. The judges are looking for a full 180 degree split. That is a requirement. Front aerial. little bit of a break there. Going to repeat it and go into her layout step out, because the reason she repeated it, she needed that connection for her bonus points to get that 10-0 start value. Would have been a very big deduction absent it. And I love the combination. She didn't quite hit it as well as she did last week. Side aerial to back. Nice long technique on that hold to us. Very laid out in the dismount. Finish strong. Unfortunately, they're going to deduct for the breakout of the first aerial walkover. Then she repeated, thank goodness, and got to do the connection.
And now on floor for LSU.
Bridget Dean will lead off for LSU on the floor. You see her score from last week, and you see the lineup.
Bridget's going to do two double backs in this routine, open with a pike double back and then finish with a tucked double back. Watch the landing. They have to show control on 2 feet first before going in the lunge. Beautiful control. Tumbling her combination passes a back 1.5 for front layout. Watch to see if she can keep a straight body. Her legs are just a little soft in both of those somersaults. Ended this routine with really two fine landings, just the middle tumbling pass and her leap pass, minor deductions for form, but love the control on first and last pass. Chest was a little bit down there.
Kathy, I love what Jay Clark says about her. She worked so hard to make the lineup. She willed her way into relevancy and made sure that the team needed her in the lineup. Well done for this young lady. Here are the points of emphasis on the beam, Kathy.
Well, we'll look for the dance and acro skills and the level of difficulty in both. And we talked about the connections in the previous routine. You have to get those to get your bonus points. There's her acro series, the back handspring layout step out. And then, of course, balance. Throughout the entire routine, they have to maintain perfect balance. No extra arm movements. There she can. It's hard to say. They had such a strong start last week. It may be the nerves of just being in a position to possibly beat LSU. I'm sure that was in the back of their mind. So it's real easy to get tight and try not to make mistakes on balance beam instead of being aggressive and attacking everything. So unfortunately, that's a fall, 5/10 of a point off. Of course, that will be the routine score they'd like to drop, and a missed opportunity.
She did not compete last week on beam. She's in the lineup this week in place of Amanda Ellswick, who has a ankle injury, so that's why she got the call. Here are the points of emphasis on floor, Kathy.
Look for the difficulty in the tumbling. We're looking for E passes. That's the highest level of difficulty, and the top gymnasts and top teams will perform them in their floor routines.
This is senior Reagan Campbell. Bridget Dean led them off with a 9.75.
She opens with a 2.5 twist. This can be hard to land and keep in bounds. not bad, just... Double back, good control. Judges also look for the artistry in the routines and on these leaps for precise positions in the air. Shows great flexibility in her leap positions. In the landings, you want to watch that their chest is up high to show they've completed the rotation of the tumbling skill. And then no movement of the feet when they land. Just one step out is allowed. Very strong routine, good for her.
Our full day of men's basketball tomorrow on the SEC Network starts at 1 Eastern, noon Central, and is highlighted by this matchup at 6, 5 Central. Vandy looks for the upset against Scottie Pippen Jr. and number 10 Tennessee. The Vols have won the last 6 and 8 of 9 against the Commodores. And like everything else, you can also watch it on the ESPN app. On the beam now, Maggie O'Hara coming after Jillian Rutz scored a 9-0.
Swing turn, don't often see those on beam anymore. Love this combination, side aerial to back handspring, very well done. That's her acro series. Watch the second jump here. Double stag ring, that head goes back, making it a much more difficult jump. Love how she maintains the toe point throughout this routine, really creates pretty pictures. Now she had trouble with the dismount, so she's changed it for this meet to a cat leap side aerial full. She would normally do it behind the leg twisting. Great decision there.
Arkansas
she is on fire tonight. Two really excellent routines by her so far. Split jump to the double stag ring. And nice job this week finding the landing on this dismount.
And now on floor for LSU, Christina
Desiderio, the senior from Hackettstown, New Jersey, will be next up for LSU. You see last week had a 9-8-5 on floor.
So happy to see her doing her full difficulty on this event. She's going to open with a double layoff.
Scores in for Reagan Campbell. It's a 9-8 after Bridget Dean led them off with a 9-7-5.
Really lack rotation. Did get it around to her feet, but pretty big deduction for the chest down and under rotation and step forward. Position in the air. It looks like she's just a little bit out of energy here. They weren't quite as big as they needed to be. Tuck double back and just pulled that around. Out. Endurance was the problem here. Even from the very beginning, it was just a little underpowered on that first pass. Even her leaps were a little bit underpowered.
Kathy, you know, all the coaches in the NCAA have told us because of COVID that a lot of their preseason conditioning prep, endurance training is behind. Most teams are telling us they're about a month behind. Perhaps we're seeing a little bit.
Exactly. And this is the second meet, so back-to-back weekends of competing when you're slightly behind on that timeline can make it challenging.
Sarah Schaefer coming up after Maggie O'Hara had her second career high of the day. She got a 9.95 on bars and a 9.925 for that incredible routine on beam.
Now this is a reset routine for Sarah. She had two falls last week. She can be gorgeous on this event, just needs to be calm, aggressive, really attack everything. Back row series, back handspring, layout, step out. Perfect this week. Back aerial, just a slight check, lifted that foot up to correct her balance, slight deduction, but such a huge improvement over last week. Top leap, side aerial full. This is how you get back on. When you've had a routine the week before with two falls, this is what you want to happen and what you want to see happen. She had fallen last week here. Notice how she just really was aggressive and attacked the landing. Stayed focused from start to finish on this routine. Well done.
Sarah Edwards coming after Christina Desiderio scored only 9-4. You see Edwards' score last week.
And watch how she takes off on her run. She's like a rocket pocket here. She just takes these little steps. They are so power-packed, though. Run double full, nice control. Front full, good difficulty on her combination pass to twist both elements.
So great to see so much explosive power in those legs. After the fourth meet last year, she had an injury and did not get to complete the rest of the season. It's great to have her back.
Wow! Oh. Super high. Now that's a stick. On 2 feet, well done. No problem with energy or endurance here. This puts a smile on my face. Great to see her back in the lineup. No movement of the feet there.
And now on beam for Arkansas. So
we know that Arkansas was nearly 3/4 of a point behind after two events, but the last two scored, look at that, 9.925 and 9.9. So they have a chance to get back on track here if they can get two more solid routines. Sophia Carter's up now.
And Sophia's just lovely on this event. I love the way she lifts through her center. A handspring layout step out, just floats it, lands so softly. But notice how she lifts up out of her hips, stretches up through her center, and then uses that on these leaps and jumps to elevate them. She literally lifts her center of gravity. That aerial, very solid to a gorgeous Sison.
She missed a connection last week and only scored 9.75.
She had a slight hesitation between those two skills last week. No problem this week. Excellent work so far. Beautiful polish, excellent presentation, poise. Had the slide hop back, but was absolutely gorgeous on the beam. This is a photographer's dream where you just can't get her in a bad position. Toes are always pointed, posture always good.
Okay, coming up now, the 1-2 punch for LSU, Haley Bryant. You see her score last week, second highest score in the country, or second to only to her teammate, Gaia Johnson.
And wait till you see the difficulty in her passes, and it's unique difficulty. You don't often see a double front, E pass, right here. Woo!
Wow.
That's fantastic.
See why she was SEC's Freshman of the Week last week.
Front lay to Rudy. An excellent technique and form. Beautiful switch half. Check this out. You'll often see this as someone's first pass on the floor, front double twist. Love this routine. The level of difficulty in the tumbling is one thing, but she's very multidimensional on floor exercise. Look at that front double. Look at the air awareness. She knows exactly where she is in the air, opens it out, and controls the landing.
For Arkansas.
Kennedy Hamrick will be the last performer for Arkansas on the beam, coming after three scores 9-9 or better. O'Hara's 9-9-2-5, Schaefer's 9-9, Sophia Carter just got a 9-9. So this could be a big finish for Arkansas, and do they need it?
Kennedy had a career high last week, 9-9-2-5. She has the routine to do it. Handspring layout, step up. Oh! It's a leg check balance. When you lift your leg that high, it's a pretty significant deduction. Nice job. I'd like to see a little bit more toe point at the very height of those leaps, especially when the rest of the leap is so good. A little bit off in that position in the air, in that straddle position. I'm impressed with the posture and the presentation of Arkansas on balance beam. Caitlin is the beam coach for Arkansas. She's doing a really nice job working with these athletes, preparing them for competition.
Jordan Weaver says she really likes her coaching staff. Chris Brooks is really in charge of bars. Caitlin Oral on the beam. Felicia Hano, the former UCLA star, is handling vault. And Jordan herself really loves working floor exercise with her team. So each of the coaches have their own special areas. Last week, Kaya Johnson gave us a thrill, scored a 10. Haley Bryant just now notched a 9.95.
Second half of this dynamic duo. Huge tumbling pass. Full twisting double back. Much better landing than last week. Back one and a half. Really does those leaps so nicely.
LSU hoping to replace that 9-4 from Desiderio. This could be their fifth big score.
can finish just as strong as she starts the routine. So much power. See if she can control the landing. High double back, a step forward. Great routine. Unfortunately, when you step forward at the end of a tumbling pass, it shows that you're slightly under-rotated and is usually a little bit more of a deduction.
So that wraps up the third of four rotations. LSU will go to the beam, and the host, Jim Bax, will be on the floor when we come back. Every Friday night and next week, our doubleheader starts in Columbia with number 8 Kentucky taking on number 14 Missouri at 7 Eastern, 6 Central. Then it's number 9 Auburn and number 4 Alabama from Coleman Coliseum in Tuscaloosa. Take a look at the road to nationals. This is the national rankings as of week 1. Florida had the big score in the country with a 197.5. Oklahoma not far behind with a 197.45. And you see the two teams competing head-to-head today, LSU and Arkansas, 5th and 6th in the NCAA rankings. Let's check out the SEC honors for this past week. The SEC Gymnast of the Week is Florida's Trinity Thomas, who won 4 event titles in the season opener. The SEC Co-Specialist of the Week, Alabama's Makari Doggett, who won 2 event titles in her season opener, and Florida's Naya Reed, who scored a 9-9 on the vault. The SEC Freshman of the Week is LSU's Haley Bryant, who made her debut against number 15 Arkansas, placing first on vault with a 9-9. You see the score on your screen there. LSU in control of this one. They squandered a little bit of their lead in that rotation, but when we come back, the fourth and final rotation in this SEC matchup. On tonight as well, freshman Haley Bryant having a terrific week, her second week in the row. She leads over Schaefer, Johnson, and Hambrick. The team competition, LSU, .725. No change from the second rotation as we move to the fourth rotation, and you can see the beam rotation for last week. I think Jay Clark told us, I'd say there was a little nerves when you look at this. They led off with a 9.875, and then they had 3 subpar routines in there, maybe 4 subpar routines for LSU. And so if they're going to hold on to the lead tonight over Arkansas, who will be comfortable on the floor, they are going to need to hold it together right now on beam. Elena Arenas is going to be first up, and that was a last-minute lineup change. Prior to this rotation, we thought Christina Desiderio would be going in the lineup, but Arenas gets the call.
Well, hopefully Christina Desiderio didn't sting those ankles too badly. Maybe they're just being safe, but this is a great opportunity to really not just work the depth, but to allow somebody else to take this lead-off position. It's such an important position on balance beam. And last week, you're right, it's almost like they They all kind of stepped out of the driver's seat to see if the car would drive itself. And on beam, it just really got to stay in control, stay focused, calm and aggressive. Hansman layout, step out. Nice to see her really follow through and finish strong.
She was a bit shaky last week, 9.575.
Nice job with the back leg on that first leap. A lot of gymnasts really forget that back leg, and it's often a little low on those leaps. Routine, good for her. Couple little deductions in there, nothing major though, so great start for LSU.
LSU, 12 of the 18 people on the team. All right, we're back. Six seniors over there. So here's the lead, 0.725. Ryan Big Johnson, 2.995s to close that rotation for LSU on the floor. As we go now to Arkansas on the floor. Abby Johnson will lead them off.
And Abby brings so much energy to her floor routine. Loves to perform. And loves to go big. Opens with a tuck double back. Nice height. Notice how she kept that front foot planted on the floor as she stepped back in the lunge.
Had a 9.8 last week. And Jordan Weber was telling us this week they were really focusing on the details, right, Kathy?
Absolutely. What she really wants to see from this team is more performance this week. Back with a half front full. Popa. This will be a pike double back. See if she can get an equally good landing. Nice job. Strong routine. A lot of energy in that performance.
For Arkansas.
So on these landings, what the judges want to see is the feet land on both feet and keep that front foot planted in the floor when you step back to the lunge. If it slides back or hops back, it's a deduction. Sammy Durante on beam. Have loved watching her career evolve, going from a bar specialist and adding events each year. She trains all four. Hands bring layout, step out, a little bit of a check there.
I wonder if anyone else noticed the background music that Arkansas is playing is Free Falling from Tom Petty. Hope that doesn't get in her head.
Nice adjustment because she was slightly turned out of that front aerial, but she kept moving into the split jump to get that connection. Switch lead to straddle quarter. Sets up for the dismount, side aerial to a full and a very nice landing on that. Strong routine.
All right, Razorback fans, it's time to get out of your feet and make some noise.
Madison Hickey will be second up on beam for Arkansas. Abby Johnston, a career high 9.875 on floor in that opening rotation. So she has done her part to help Arkansas on floor in this final rotation.
Opens with a pike double back. This is the event that Jordan Weber coaches, and she is like a floor whisperer. She has had so much success. She gets them so prepared before season for the endurance part of floor exercise. Tuck double back, oh, short of rotation, step forward. The biggest deduction will be that last tumbling pass. Remember when I said if you step forward out of a back tumbling pass, it indicates that it was slightly underdone. You really want to take that step back into the lunge.
Hats off to all these young ladies and the coaches for doing their best to stick to these COVID protocols. As you can tell, there's a smaller audience. Athletes are required to wear masks when they're not performing, and everyone is working hard to make sure that these young athletes can have a safe and successful season as Haley Bryant takes to the beam after Elena Arenas had a 9.825 and Sammy Durrani a 9.85.
Nice front aerial to the back handspring. Switch lead to a straddle quarter for her dance series. Seeing so much poise from this freshman. Nice punch front. You can see her smile is almost choreographed into this routine. Definitely helps you relax in the routine. And a punch, Rudy. Really strong landing. Nice job from the freshman.
Jay Clark gave her a great compliment the other day. He said, I don't think she really knows how good she is.
She's pretty nonplussed. It's very refreshing to see. If there's not a buzz around the nation about both Kaia Johnson and Haley Bryant, they're really a strong duo.
Madison Hickey's score is in for Arkansas on floor 9.625. This brings up Sarah Schaefer.
Sarah uses her height so well to command attention on this event. Watch this very open double pike. Gorgeous position and control on the landing. I mean, that's how you milk a landing. Back 1.5 front layout. Nice work of her leaps. Strong finish, good control. Excellent Sarah routine.
Schaefer for Arkansas.
Love getting another look at this first pass. Watch her open out of the pike right there. Sees the landing. Perfect control.
Last week was her first time in the all-around in a while, and she's doing it again tonight. Nice job there. Bridget Dean, what a thrill she gave LSU in a crucial 9-9 last week on beam when they were struggling with nerves. First meet against Arkansas back down in Baton Rouge.
Nice combination coming up here. Side aerial to the back handspring. Love that we're seeing this series performed more. We see a lot of back handspring layout step outs for the Acro series. Nice position in those split leap and split jump. Beautiful alignment on that front aerial, perfectly square with the beam. She can stick this landing, certainly one of her very best routines. Oh, little hop on the landing. Love the routine though, nice job. Really focused, strong, aggressive from start to finish. A little bit of knee bend in that laid out position, just something she needs to work on.
She was coming up after Haley Bryant had a 9-9, so a big score could be there for her. Bailey Lovett coming after Sarah Schaefer from Arkansas notched a 9-9. Well rewarded for that clean execution.
Watch how she finesses this first pass. This double layout takes a lot of power, but she's really in that stretch tight arch throughout the double layout, makes it really pretty. I like how she steps and goes into the fuete double stag right out of the combination tumbling pass. Loses her toe point just a little bit at the top of those leaps. That's a tiny little thing she can fix. Look at the amplitude on that tuck double back and the chené, jeté and double stag. Nice dynamic choreography to finish the routine. Wow, the height off the floor was really exceptional. This double back just continues to rise. She lifts and lifts where center of gravity. The second somersault is higher than the first. Who does that?
She is deceptively powerful. Well done. Kaya Johnson, now you see last week she struggled on beam with only a 9.275, but note this, she's coming up after Bridget Dean got their second 9.9 in a row for LSU, and that is Dean's career high.
Well, Kaya is as tough as anyone. She can come back from that and so well trained on this event. My guess is it was just a fluke last week. She will attack, follow through, finish strong, just like I expected. No. She was a little off on the first leap. Her arms got out of whack, so I knew she was slightly off. I thought she could pull it back on by the second jump, but. Oh, no. Hang on. Okay, she's obviously not going to be pleased with this routine, but it's a process, and sometimes you have to live through these.
Coach Clark told us that she has Achilles tenderness, so they're really trying to manage the numbers on pounding events.
That's hard on an event like this. Numbers is where you get that consistency. Look at that. Beautiful double twist on the landing. So did a lot of things well in the beginning of that routine. I really thought that it was going to continue through the whole routine.
Last week, Kennedy Hambrick had a 9-9. She's coming after Bailey Lovett's 9-9, who followed Sarah Schaefer's 9-9. So Arkansas, really strong on floor here so far.
Big double tuck. Not a lot of difficulty in the first pass, but really well done. Her second pass may be my favorite. I love this. It's just pretty and interesting. A Rudy to a layout, double stag.
Kathy, all of their gymnasts really get off the floor. They have great pop and excellent technique.
They have Jordan written all over them. this is something that Jordan did so well as a competitor. And they pay equal attention to the tumbling, the technique for the tumbling, which is what you have to be able to do to really get yourself off the floor and show that amplitude. Watch the lift off the floor. And they really lift the center of gravity up too. Great job. It's nice to see them put together complete routines. Just attention to the detail, the really good technique in their tumbling.
And now, on beam for LSU, Reagan Campbell.
Critical routine for LSU on the beam. Reagan Campbell is the anchor performer. She's coming after Kaya Johnson, had a low 905. So LSU needs a hit here.
Well, Reagan earned this anchor position for a reason, and she can handle this kind of pressure. You really have to embrace it. You have to love it. A little bit of a check there, out of the full turn. Very nice on the front aerial to the Sison. Really nice position on that first leap. Was a little bit short on the half turn on the switch half. Round of double twist, great landing. Super job for her in the anchor position. A lot of pressure, she handled it beautifully.
Hands together.
Nines in a row for Arkansas on the floor. The last one for Kennedy Hambrick. That brings up Sophia Carter. Look at her score last week. This is always a treat, Kathy.
I love the way she performs on floor with her full body, full energy between every arm movement, every gesture, every facial expression. Beautiful execution on the double tuck. This is a much more flirty, fun routine than last year. Beautiful on those twisting elements. finishes with a pike double back. Excellent chest position. Love the flourish and the finish. I just love the polish of this gymnast. Great footwork, great posture and presentation, and the full energy behind her dance.
We are currently finalizing individual and team scores and will announce both the individual and team results from this evening's competition.
How fun.
What a great finish for Arkansas on the floor. There were 3.99s coming into that. And when we come back, we'll have her score and wrap this one up. What a fun day of gymnastics in the home and home series. LSU improved significantly from week one. Their final score, 197.225, is almost 7/10 of a point. It gives you an all-access pass to the national championship game between Alabama and Ohio State for never-before-seen footage and sounds. And Sunday we'll have a special gymnastics doubleheader for you. It all starts at 3 Eastern with number 1 Florida hosting number 7 Georgia. Then it's number 2 Oklahoma hosting number 3 Utah. Both meets will be on ESPN2. Tonight's final score here in Fayetteville. LSU significantly improved over last week, nearly 7/10 of a point higher, a 197.225. And Arkansas improved by nearly 3/10 of a point from their opening meet with a 196.625. The all-around champion, Haley Bryant, was spectacular in this effort. Kathy, weren't you impressed by all the work she did?
Oh, absolutely. And her lowest score was on her best event, the vault. And I believe that's the event she has a 10 awaiting her later in the season. Every event, she has so much talent, and it's spread across from power, technique, presentation. The level of difficulty in her floor routine from start to finish, open with a front top double front, and then comes back at the end with a front double full. This is an exciting gymnast to watch, and she's only just begun.
Haley Bryant's all-around score, you see there, that 39.6. The only gymnast in the country so far to score higher than her this year in the all-around is Florida's Trinity Thomas. Well, that does it from Fayetteville, Arkansas, the home and home series. LSU won them both back in Baton Rouge, and today here in Fayetteville. Final score, 197.225 for LSU and 196.625 for Arkansas. For Kathy Johnson-Clark, I'm Bart Connor. We're glad you joined us. The SEC gymnastics season is just getting underway and it's already terrific. So long from Fayetteville, everybody. Thanks for watching.